Somebody says a whole bunch of stuff I need. Somebody say, well, how you get it? It's simple. All you got to do is enter his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise. Be thankful and bless his holy name. Y'all got to turn on your revelation radar. Just look around. You see anything you need? That passage only suggests, like, you have gone to the grocery store with a gift card that has no limit, and it just said, go in there and get what you need. Get your 2 or 3 baskets and fill it up. But the only thing you got to do is, when you get to the counter, is enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts. Y'all see me paying the bill, don't you? With praise, be thankful. I'm swiping my card. Unto him, and bless. And when you bless God's name, it always comes back approved, all right? Oh, because when you really become passionate about a point or a place of deliverance in your life, you're not concerned about anything else other than the point of freedom and deliverance in your life. And you won't get it if you're still focusing. Deliverance is not going to harass you. Deliverance will not accost you. Deliverance will not assault you. Y'all like them words? Deliverance will not overtake you. Deliverance is a thing that you have to go after. What do you mean, Pastor? Why you have to go after it? Because you must understand now. But these movie directors are so prophetic. Because Elder Smith, they didn't read Paul, I'm sure, but Paul says there is a war in my members. There's a law that is warring. There's a law in my members that is warring, fighting against the law of my mind. Watch this. Now, apparently, her feet got saved, but her heart is still bound. All right, her feet got delivered, but her eyes are still bound. So watch. Now, here's the war, because the bottom half of her is going this way, but the top half of her is still focusing on this. So it suggests that she has not overcome the war. Ask your neighbor, have you overcome? See, because the only way I can overcome the thing I need to be delivered from is that when I can get all of me. And watch this. Let me tell you something. You won't be delivered until you can get all of you to agree it's time to be delivered.
That's right.
In other words, watch this. Not only must your spirit be frustrated, but you'll come to a place now where your flesh will start to get irritated and start talking to, and now you're talking to yourself, you crazy, because you still doing this, you still going there, you still saying this, you're still feeling this way. You are crazy. You know, maybe I am crazy. I need to be delivered. Now, that ain't the spirit man talking, that's your flesh talking. And now, once all of you, well, the old folk, you say, sometimes you got to get sick and tired. Once all of you gets tired of that situation, it's hard to be delivered when spiritually you know you need to change, but physically you don't want to change.
That's right.
Spiritually, I know I need to change. Physically, I don't want to change. You destined to fall. Tell somebody, Jason is going to catch you. You can call him Jason, you can call Freddy, but let's really get deep. Satan, Leviathan, Lucifer, Bel. He gonna catch you. Watch this. This is the part of me This is the part of me that's at church running. This is the part of me. This is the part of me, mother, that's at church running around. This is the part of me that's looking back. And this can only operate without this for so long. So here's what's destined to happen. Now you find yourself running back to the thing with the same intensity that last week you were running from it. Because you've got to deliver your. You have to not saw. You have to escape. And you have to become convinced in all of you. Mind, body, and soul. Yes, it. Mind, body, and soul. Beat him with the rod. You won't kill him. You'll save his soul from hell. Y'all be all right.
That's the word. That's the word.
It's all right. And there comes the praise. After every trial. After every trial. Comes the praise. Oh, that's prophetic too. Because he wasn't saying nothing before he went through. But once he, I'm preaching to y'all now, but once he went through, sometimes your trial will produce a praise. Y'all still laughing. Y'all think I'm playing, but I'm really talking to you. Sometimes it takes your suffering to get the shout out of you. That's why Jonah said it was when I was in the belly of Sheol that I cried out to God. That's why I preach. You ought to thank God for hell. You ought to thank God for everything you went through, everything you suffered, everything you lost, because it was those things that brought you to this place of worship and thanksgiving that you are right now.